See, the next speaker, and he is the final speaker for the day, is a mechanical engineer, and he is going to address smoke extraction systems.
My topic is smoke extraction. Smoke caused by fire is a killer. Everyone knows there are more deaths due to smoke than actual fire. Actually, due to smoke, there are many times that the visibility also becomes very poor, and the occupants of the building end up in the wrong direction because they are not able to see the signages. There may be signages, there may be lots of systems available for fire extraction, but since they are not, their visibility is poor, they end up in the wrong direction. There is a classic example of Kamalabail fire, where there were a lot of people who ended up in a toilet and they were killed by smoke. Maintenance of smoke extraction system. You may install a very efficient and very well designed smoke extraction, but if you don't maintain it properly, then at the time when it's required the most, it will not be functional. So simple things like checking fire signal, checking the cable connections, checking the cleaning the blades and the safety grills of the fans. Periodically, the smoke extraction system must be checked by giving a fire signal. Let's look at the design criteria. Which are the locations where smoke extraction system is required as a mandatory? Fire escape corridors, lift lobbies should be provided with smoke extract system. Staircases should be pressurized. Car parking should be provided with ventilation as well as smoke extraction system. Smoke extraction through fire escape corridors and lift lobbies are normally done through a ducted system, and then they are connected to the fire extraction fans, which should be fire rated. The operation of the fans is by receiving signal from the smoke and fire detection systems. The staircase pressurization is very important, because when people are advised not to use the lifts for escaping in case of fire, they will use the fire exit staircase, but if there is smoke and fire in the staircase, they will also not be able to escape. So the staircase pressurization should be designed in such a way that even if three of the fire exit doors are open, still there should be a positive pressure of 50 pascals. The pressurization fans also run on fire signal. Car park ventilation will have normally in their design two aspects, a normal mode and a fire mode. In case of normal mode, where CO contaminant is exceeding the limit, that time the fans start running at a slower speed, and in case of fire, they start running at the higher speed. The exhaust fans will be fire rated up to 250 degrees centigrade for 2 hours. The jet fans are also to be fire rated, and they will also run at two speed. Normally typical used are say 3500 CFM at slower speed and 7000 CFM at fire mode speed. The fresh air is allowed inside the area either through floor cutouts or it can be used through force draft fans. The jet fans look something like this. And this is the profile of the air, the way air is pushed with the help of jet fans. CO sensors are, they will trigger the operation of the jet fans at to operate at the lower speed, and in turn they will trigger the operation of the smoke extract fans, which are the exhaust fans. We will take a case study. We have put a case study where there are some three cars which are in cold cars. Cold car is what is car which has just started. It emits low heat but high amount of CO. Hot car is a car which is has run for a long time. It emits lot of heat but less amount of CO. There are some still cars and there's a system of jet fans and smoke exhaust fans. In case of smoke, we are considering one burning car. This is the basement which has 5 jet fans, 8 exhaust fans, and in the opposite location there's a cutout for fresh air to come in. The circles are indicating the range where CO sensor is giving signal to the jet fans. The exhaust fans can be through cutout and may be enclosed like this. As just now Mr. Gujarati said, that you may be ending up spoiling your landscaping, but smoke extraction is a very important element. Please do not compromise on that. Let us take a glimpse at the CFD analysis. This is the same basement. Now during CFD analysis, we study graphically the smoke contaminant temperature 60 degrees centigrade or above, visibility greater than 10 meters or above, and air velocity of 0.25 meters per second or above. This is a graphical representation of CO contaminant at 1.7 meter height. As per ASHRAE standards, threshold is 25 ppm for 8 hours exposure and 35 ppm for 1 hour exposure. The second graph is showing the jet fan profile. Just getting a glimpse of CFD analysis at the time of smoke, where one car is burning, it will generate approximately 4 megawatt of heat. Graphically, it shows that the temperature above 60 degrees centigrade, almost for 80-90% of the area, and smoke contaminant for almost 80% of the area. Visibility also very low, less than 10 meters for 80-90% of the area. So when in the CFD analysis you trigger the smoke exhaust system, in the fire mode, visibility 90% of the area more than 10 meters, temperature less than 60 degrees for more than 70-80% of the area, and smoke within the acceptable limit for 80-90% of the area. That will save the people in that area. Thank you.